It is time for the 2016 PWBA Tour on CBS Sports Network. The Greater Detroit Open Finals features four of the best bowlers in the world, all competing for prize money and a tour title. Welcome, everyone, to Bowling on CBS Sports Network. Great to have you with us alongside Tour superstar Kelly Kulick. I'm Dave Ryan. And Kelly, three of our four finals, international stars, trying to make a big impact here today.
Yeah, you know, Dave, we've had three winners so far this year, one from Singapore. Now, going in the stepladder finals, we have Tanya Rumenpier from Indonesia. She will face Stephanie Johnson in the opening match. Lee Jane from Malaysia, qualified second seed. And that winner will go on to face Rocio Restrepo from Colombia, looking for her first title this year.
Stephanie Johnson, season to date, Kelly. She's bowled very well. Reigning Rookie of the Year.
Yeah, look at Stephanie's stats. I mean, they speak for herself. She's only missed one cashing event, and that was at the Sonoma County Open. She finished fourth at the Players' Championship, and now she's looking for her first title of the 2016 season for the Greater Detroit Open.
Won in Wichita last year. What about her game do you like right now?
Stephanie's game is so sound. Her physical fundamentals are solid. She's got great ball speed, great leverage through the delivery, and with her ball speed, she's going to create a lot of pin action.
She'll try to top Rocio Restrepo, who's at the top of her game.
Yeah, Rocio's been channeling something within her inner self. She's been looking for guidance. She's worked with Del Ballard and Hank Boomershine from the Storm Company. Being the first seed's got to boost her confidence. She might walk away with her first title.
Kelly, when we come back, and it's time to bowl, only one PWBA bowler will take home the 2016 PWBA Greater Detroit Open Finals title.
Who will it be? Stay locked in here at CBS Sports Network to find out.
It's time to bowl on CBS Sports Network, the PWBA Greater Detroit Open Stepladder Finals. And Kelly, let's check in with the future for the sport, lane pattern.
Well, Dave, the girls, we all bowled on 44 feet of oil this week, a high volume of oil, about 30 milliliters. It kind of Christmas trees. So the girls are going to play in the middle part of the lane and kind of keep the three pin in play at all times for all righties on the lane itself. Curve oil is what they're using, very friendly, but it's going to create a lot of hook. So all the girls are going to play in the same part of the lane and make the adjustments, see how they break down over time.
Tanya Rumenpier will lead things off.
Longtime member of the Indonesian national team. And the lone American will step up next in Stephanie Johnson.
Now, Tanya's no stranger to the telecast. She's been on a telecast in previous years. 16-17 at the arrows. High on the head pin. Catches a lucky break through the face to carry the strike.
Sometimes you need that early break to springboard you into a really good TV show. We'll find out.
Absolutely. Stephanie Johnson, 32 years of age, one title underneath her belt.
Just outside Dallas, Grand Prairie. Good shot to begin things for Stephanie Johnson.
One of my fellow teammates on Team USA. What she does so well is she keeps her angles nice and tight and her arm swing always in front of her. Right around 12 or 13, hits the 1-3 flush. Pins have nowhere to go except back. Strike is on the board.
4 years, junior Team USA, 12 years, senior Team USA. Great international career for Stephanie Johnson. Now ready to make some noise again for a second straight year on the PWBA Tour. Second frame. Oh, 10 down, locked in early. Stephanie Johnson.
Four-step approach. Push away goes slightly forward. Hand action at the bottom of the swing. Here's about 14-15 at the break point, right around 44 feet. Again, that's the length of the pattern itself. Not going to give the pocket away.
Rumenpier next up. Comes in high. 6-10 stands for Tanya.
Just a young age of 26 years old. Looking for her first title. Became a member of the tour this year, all the way from Indonesia. We have just been pulling from the best pool of world bowlers all around coming out for this ladies' tour.
Covers it 6-10 nicely. Former collegiate star at Wichita State, a powerhouse program on the men's and women's side. Second
at the International Singles Intercollegiate Singles Championships, back-to-back years, 2013 and 2014.
Two-time most valuable player collegiately. We saw her in a telecast a few years ago on the Queens. Third frame.
Ball 10 down. No 7-10 there for Tanya, but any player who does convert a 7-10 split on our CBS Sports Network finals will receive a $100,000 bonus courtesy of Ultimate Bowling Products.
Tanya's got a five-step approach. Now Del Ballard, the tour rep for the Storm Products, told her to keep it just inside that tracer down the lane. By doing that, she's almost like the ball is going directly towards the three pin, just tips up, makes that subtle motion inward towards the pocket. Stephanie working on a double, though, going into the third frame with a 10-pin lead.
In the groove. Really good start for our bowlers here.
Let's look at Stephanie's approach. Four steps, big first step. Gets the ball past the swing. On the second step, more heel toe. Look how steady her head is. All the girls have had that backswing where it's just slightly higher than the shoulder itself. Foot comes to a complete stop through. Trail leg nice tucked behind her. And wow, what long limbs, what long arms she has to give that projection, that trajectory through the front part of the lane.
Looks for the front four. Perfect start. Doesn't continue. 4-7 stands for Stephanie.
As we see on this delivery, she's slightly inside of where she was. She's around 16-17. That one not quite far as right. Here's board 15 from this indicator. So not as far right down the lane. Comes up high into the pocket. Two-pin wraps itself around 4-7.
No 300 game here for either of our competitors, but any player who does bowl 300 game on our CBS Sports Network Finals receives a $10,000 bonus. Picks up the spare, has the mark, 4-7 down. That bonus from the PWBA. Back to Tanya, her fourth frame.
It's a routine within Tanya to swing her arm. She's swinging through her target, feeling the swing, the length of it. But staying in the moment is going to be her key that she keyed in all week long.
Comes it high, avoids the big four. But still the 4-6-7 to deal with.
Yeah, physically I love Tanya's delivery on that step. Five-step approach, big first step. Push the ball in on the second step. Pass the knee on the third. Gets that really quick step, that power step. Her hips are somewhat more square here. But then again, high backswing for Tanya. Left arm pulls back. Two pins on the strike equals four, but an open for Tanya in the fourth frame.
So the early open. Always interesting to see how that affects the match.
10 frames, a lot of frames in one game.
Her numbers heading into the TV show.
223 average, 4-2 in match play. We've seen a lot of high averages this year on the tour itself.
All 10 down for the National Collegiate Bowling Coaches Association MVP. National Player of the Year, back-to-back years, 2012-13 and 2013-14. Dual degree from Wichita State. Some assistance from tour rep Del Ballard. Hall of Famer himself.
Looking at Stephanie's stats, she averaged higher than Tanya at 228, but the match play record of 2-4, where those bonus pins come into play, still led her to be in this position today on the show.
Yes. All 10 down. And some energy and emotion from Stephanie Johnson.
Ball moves on that first step slightly forward and upward. She's got such great hand action at the bottom of her swing. Here's 47 feet at the end of the pattern. Ball's just going to tip up just ever so slightly, not change a hard direction, but a subtle one.
For good reason, great shot.
I have to say, sometimes bowling against Stephanie is tough. I'm proud to say she's my teammate, and I'm glad she's on my team for Team USA.
Gold medal last year for you, Stephanie, Team USA. All 10 down, stays hot. Has the double, fifth and sixth, and has herself a 40-pin lead. Stephanie Johnson looking for another championship. Off to a great start. Five strikes already. Detroit, Michigan. Are you looking for some great PWBA gear? Then visit the official online store of the PWBA at shoppwba.com. 40-pin lead, Stephanie Johnson with a double, fifth and sixth frame. Tanya can cut into the lead here, though. Reduce it to 30 pins, works on a strike, sixth frame. She needs a rally and needs it now.
Tanya!
That's how you start. Perfect hit in the 1-3 pocket, blitzing through all 10.
Tanya's been working on getting more ball speed over the past 2 or 3 years. Keeps the ball in line. Estelle Ballard said she just wants the ball to tip up and make that subtle motion towards the pocket. Great ball reaction right there. Way to bounce back. Catches the double.
Member of the Indonesian national team since 2005. Lots of success. Asian Games, Southeast Asian Games. In addition to the great career at Wichita State we told you about.
Yeah, and if you look at her shirt, it's pretty much of the world. Places she's been, places she wants to go and compete.
Comes in high, avoids the big four. But the very difficult 6-7-10.
That had a push. Didn't have enough push down the lane. Slightly inward. 17-18 at the arrows. She's right around board 15 at Stephanie is, but she's using a strong, aggressive bowling ball. And at the end, when it sees the friction, it just tips too hard.
Trying to kick it across the deck for the seven, but cannot convert. Takes the count instead. And on the bench, Stephanie Johnson sees that lead grow. She's in great shape to advance into the seventh frame. Was last year's gold the highlight for Team USA in your time with Stephanie?
It was, actually. We lost to Korea in Vegas 2 years prior to that. And one thing that we did with our team coach, Rod Ross, at the ITRC International Training Research Center, we practiced on short. And for us to overcome that victory and win on the short pattern, we worked and trained for that moment, and we won it full and outright with Liz shooting 300 in that final match.
Tupin this time trying to grow the lead. In the seventh frame, was looking for the turkey.
Now long oil pattern, so the ball has to stay on line. Definitely more left to right. She's right around board 11, where before she's about 2 or 3 boards inside of that. Enough surface on the bowling ball to get it to change direction, just enough. Help, help, help. Two pin. Makeable spare.
Converts without a problem. Stat pack coming your way. The key numbers. Great start for Stephanie. First three. The double before the 9-pin spare in the seventh. Works on the spare here, eighth frame, 44-pin lead in the driver's seat. Can she finish? That's the question. Looks that way. She's locked in.
That is a fundamentally sound delivery. Sliding around 25-26. Controlling the pocket, hitting the 1-3. It's almost as if the girls are shooting the 3-pin spare, just keeping directly on line. really letting the ball do the work. Angles nice and tight. Arm swing right in front of them. Keep the ball in play.
Robin Purr in serious trouble.
Oh.
Eight pin.
Oh, Dave, that hurt me. One of the toughest leaves for all the bowlers to leave. She's also about 25, keeps the ball on line, keeping it near that tracer mark. Wow, stone eight pin. What happens is the five pin just doesn't go into the eight pin itself and the ball just passes it by. Almost whistle as it goes by.
Tough break. That was the eight for her mark. Lee Jane Sin awaits the winner of this match. Number two seed. Trying to climb the ladder. Sierra Strepo of Colombia. Now lives in Louisville, Ohio, is the top seed.
Ninth frame, Tanya makes a great shot. Flat 10 pin though. She spares here. Let's look at this delivery. Footwork is so pristine. Same point of the arrow zone. Again, right on target. She's right around 12. She's been somewhat in that zone. 2 to 3 boards. Professionals will keep the ball within their target an inch and a quarter every single time. That is on the outside and the inside.
There's the mark. Tanya, dual major at Wichita State in communications and psychology. 26. She'll be back, no question about that. Right now, Stephanie's job is just to finish this one off and climb the ladder in match number one. Huge lead. Works on a strike into the foundation frame.
And now Stephanie has a great lead against Tanya. She's most likely going to win this match, so she's going to make a ball change, kind of get a little information as what the lanes are doing. Maybe a different reaction, different motion as it's going through the pins.
Let's see how it responds. Pretty well, ring a 10 pin.
Yep, smoother transition of the ball going down the lane. She's not going to move much, going to stay in the same part of the lane that she has been in. 25, same part of the arrows, 16, 17, 18. Just inside, right around 13, 14, the ball is just going to make a subtle motion, but deflect slightly. The other ball she was using was rolling through the pins more aggressively. That one deflected.
Johnson has wrapped this matchup. And there's the 10 pin. It's just a matter of the final score, but she will advance up the ladder. Lee Jane Sin from Perak, Malaysia. 24 years old, awaits Stephanie Johnson in the next round.
She's going to stick with that same ball in the left lane. A little of information, a little guidance. Yeah. 2-5 spare.
Not the pocket hit you wanted.
No, it was a great shot in the right lane. But that ball is either burning up and losing too much energy trying to get its way back towards the pocket.
Two five knocks it down for the spare. And Stephanie Johnson has wrapped up match number one. Lee Jane Sin, the two seed from Malaysia, awaits Stephanie Johnson in our second match. Each player trying to get up to the top seed, Rocio Restrepo. Stephanie Johnson from the Dallas Metroplex. Win over Tanya Raminpour. 222-181, climbing the ladder. Looking for a PWBA title. Watch live early round coverage of all PWBA events, plus live and on-demand coverage of all the best professional bowling action on Extra Frame. Visit www.extraframe.tv for more info or to subscribe today. And Kelly, Tour is back for a second year after the hiatus, and you are going all over the country, aren't you guys?
Yes, we started on the West Coast, made our way towards the Midwest. We have the Detroit Open Finals coming to you right now. Then we're going to make our way to the East Coast in Rochester, Lexington, all the way down to Florida, Houston, Texas for the Lucy Doubles, and finishing off in Addison, Illinois for the U.S. Open.
Great schedule ahead. Have the action for you on CBS Sports Network. Lee Jansen from Malaysia. Great start. Hammers through the 1-3 pocket with velocity.
Team Malaysia, Lee Jane. Very aggressive. 15-16 at the arrows. Dale said keep it just in the inside of that tracer mark. Great opening first shot. We saw her earlier this year in the Queen's performance.
Stephanie, her second match, looking for help on the 7, a nudge, but it stands. Single pin conversion coming up for her.
Yeah, Stephanie was playing with a different bowling ball in that last game, for some information. She made another ball change. Hand gets just a little bit out inside of the ball. Doesn't have enough energy to get back. 7 pin. Hard plastic ball straight at the spare.
How much experimentation will you do, Kelly, in a situation like that?
It depends on how much of the match, if I'm ahead, if I'm really trying to find something else, if I'll give up a frame to get the next 3 or 4. But it has to be done. Once you get to the show, Dave, you really can't miss, because everyone's going to be at the top of their game. You know, very seldom do we see a lot of blowout matches. Usually they're close. But Stephanie's sticking with the same ball now in the left lane after the first match.
Stephanie, Rookie of the Year, PWBA Tour last year. Husband Chris, former PBA Rookie of the Year.
Bowling is in the family.
That's pretty rare, isn't it? And son Levi, watching at home. The Dallas area and watching mom cross through all 10 back into the pit. Great shot.
Yeah, Stephanie is so aggressive. She's got great ball speed. Again, keeps her angles right in front of her, nice tight lines. Look at the break point down here. She's right at about almost 40 feet, right inside 12-13.
Can send respond. This time, it does get a pretty good count out of the shot that missed the pocket. 2 pin up.
Yeah, bounces back. Catches a lucky break there.
Talked about her making the Queens TV Finals in Vegas. She lost the opening match, started with 5 straight strikes, an incredible beginning. Then a pair of splits, costly in a 242-224 loss to Birgit Puppler of Germany.
Part of Team Malaysia, she's so excited to be over here. So we look at her approach, 5 steps, slides left foot forward. Ball gets in the swing fast, heel toe. Shorter third step. But here's his power step as it crosses over. Her shoulders are open right there. Has that power step push off, longer slide. And she maintained that wrist position all the way through her delivery.
All 10 down, great shot. Malaysian national team member, a member of the Malaysian 10-pin bowling congress, the NTBC. And one of 8 have been sent by that country to compete on tour. Backed by the National Sports Council. It's great support from their country.
Yeah, Malaysia, their federation supports a lot of their players. They start them at a young age, probably around the age of 8, 10, or 12, building their youth development program so that they all can be adult competitors on the national team. Great support from the Federation.
Back to Johnson. Good looking shot, 10 pin stands. Stephanie works at Plano Super Bowl in the Dallas area alongside husband Chris. She wanted to give a shout out to Jamie Brooks, gave her that opportunity to balance her work there and competing full time on tour. That's a busy life for the Johnsons.
Chasing around Levi and holding a full-time job and bowling on the ladies tour.
It's impressive. There's a 10 for Stephanie.
Many of the ladies out here on the tour also have a full-time job. It's great that the schedule allows them to come in on a Thursday night, catch the practice session, or on Friday morning, the hour practice session, bowl the full weekend, and head back to that Monday through Friday or Monday through Thursday 9-to-5 job. The biggest key word is balance, not only at the foul line, but balancing life's challenges as they come forward.
Fourth frame, all square. And working on the spare, Stephanie strikes. Second time of the match.
Plants that slide foot. Right around the third and fourth arrow. 40 feet is right here. Ball starts to tip up. Watch the little white pin on the bowling ball. So it's more sideways and it gets taller and taller as it gets to that roll face. Now Jane on the right lane.
Needs a response and gets one. Some Team Malaysia support here for Jane Sin.
Yeah, both girls seem to have the left lane down pretty solid. So right lane could be a little bit tricky at times. Little hang spot down the lane. But for 24 games, a 227 average, 4-2 in match play. High scoring pattern that we saw for the Detroit Open. Working on a double. It's got to get there.
It does, just in time. Turkey for Sin in frames 3, 4, and 5.
I like Jane's approach. She starts the ball before she even starts the movement of her feet. Gets a little wide right. Shake or strike. Thank you. 10 straight back. A little shake or strike there for the X on the board.
Johnson down 10. Can respond here. Down 20 to be down 10 with a strike. Fifth frame. Not a bad shot again. 10-pin stands.
Ringing 10-pin.
Seen a few of those, haven't we?
Yeah, you know, again, Stephanie, she's very aggressive and firm with the ball, so she creates a lot of ball speed with a long pattern, 44 feet in length, and a lot of volume, 30 feet. So as that white pin on the ball starts to migrate, that 6-pin just goes horizontal. It doesn't bounce off the sideboard, leaves a 10-pin.
There's the 10. Stephanie told us pre-match, Kelly, about not a lot of changes in her game except opening up angles. What did she mean by that?
Well, when the girls get further deep inside the lane, somewhere past third arrow, fourth arrow, they have to go more left to right. Opening up their angles means they have to start the ball further inside and get the ball down the lane to the right in order for it to come back to the pocket. So she's been working on slowing down her ball speed a little bit, creating a little bit more rotation with her hand, and again, increasing her performance when it comes to opening up the angles, playing left to right.
Look out, it's high, it's the big four.
Such a bad break right there.
Well, the match can change so quickly. And now the nearly impossible to make big four can be done. It's difficult. Gets through the four. The four stands, nearly had it. A really good effort for Stephanie Johnson. Lee Jane Sin from Malaysia in the driver's seat. She has a big lead now. Strikes third, fourth, and fifth frames. A turkey. These were in great shape. Some more info on the PWBA Greater Detroit Open. Kent, Michigan. 112 entries, average of cash just over 211. And Kelly did not bowl in this event because of an injured ankle. I know he wanted to compete.
I did, but unfortunately, I knew I wasn't going to be 100%. Missy Parkin, though, fifth position finishing from Laguna Hills, California. making her presence. But we have Diane and Mark Voigt, proprietors at Super Bowl Lanes in Canton, Michigan. Second time hosting a Professional Women's Bowling Association event.
Great to see them here. Thanks to both them and their great staff. All their assistants. Looking for the four bagger. Out of the commercial break, that can be the big challenge. Sixth frame only, a six pin count.
Yeah, she had a shaker shot on the right lane this last time. Doesn't quite get the rotation on the hand from the last time, right around board nine, a little outside of the break point where it's been consistent for the other girls in the matches. But she leaves the bucket, 2-4-5-8.
Covers nicely. The bucket can be a challenge. Good bounce back from missing the pocket. Still in great shape in this match. Now to the second half.
Yeah, 31 pin lead for Jane. Her swing is unique too, Dave. If you watch her swing, it kind of wraps around her and tucks behind her, but she does it the same way every single time. So it's not right, it's not wrong. It's Jane's swing. Let's see if we can see it in this approach. Starts it. Right there. Strike in the seventh frame for Jane. Extends her lead over Stephanie Johnson. Let's look at this swing though. Again, so it comes, tucks behind. Then her hand gets back around at the bottom of the swing. The ball paralyzes the five pin as it's the last to fall.
Last season's Rookie of the Year needs to respond and needs to do it right now. Off the open seventh frame. Can she get the roll started? There's a strike. Head in the right direction.
Back to the replay of Stephanie. Sliding 26 at the foul line, 18 at the arrows. White pin on the ball again. Deflects slightly, but wow. X marks the spot. 5-7 for Jane, 3-7 Stephanie. One open for Stephanie Johnson with that big four.
That looks familiar. Got the bucket again.
Well, she went high last time on this lane. Maybe a bigger move with her feet and her target. Ball doesn't quite get there. 2-4-5-8.
Jane Sin was able to convert hers. Let's see if Stephanie can follow suit. Originally from the Miami area, the South Florida USBC Hall of Fame. Does cover nicely. All-American at UCF in Orlando.
Textbook conversion. Plastic ball head on that two pin. Goes straight back into the five, kicks out the 2-8.
Eighth frame works on a strike. 41 pin lead with another, but that's high. Big four up for a second. 4-7 standing for Lee Jane Sin.
So watch Jane swing here. This is what I mean. Slides that left foot and takes a big crossover step with the right. When she crosses over, see how the swing comes back behind her head? Usually it's going to be directly behind it at the top of the swing. She's going to bump it back out, and then her hand's going to rotate around it at the bottom of the swing. But she does it the same way every single time.
Four seven stays clean. That's the most important thing. Ladder frames of the match. 31 pin lead heading into the foundation frame. Rocio Restrepo from Colombia will take on the winner of this match. Another rising international star. Our top seed waits in the wings.
Solid.
Feeling it.
Anytime you hear that crispness, that sound, oh, that's the most prettiest sound you can hear as a bowler. Five-step approach again. Keeps it on target. Oh, the crispness of that strike. It's a beautiful sound.
Yeah, it sure is.
I love it. Yep.
Just explodes right through that 1-3 pocket, all 10 back. Stephanie Johnson. Desperate times. Ninth frame. Gonna have to put a lot of strikes up on the board and hope to get some help.
Yeah, Jane's max score, she can shoot 236. Stephanie can only shoot 205. Moves a little bit deeper inside that right lane. Splits the 8-9. She's getting away from that trouble spot, that little hang down the lane to the right side. Girls are gonna parallel move inward left. And still hit the 1-3.
Keeping things a little interesting here. Cuts the lead at 21 pins for Sin into the 10th frame. How many pins she can rack up here is a big question.
Yeah, again, max score for Stephanie, 205. If she strikes out here, she'd force Jane to do something in the 10th frame, mark in the 10th, get more than 9. Needs it.
Just the 4 stands. Didn't get it.
Steffi's going to shoot this Baron for a 194 match. Jane will move on and advance that final match to face Rocío Restrepo in the finals.
.194 for Stephanie Johnson. 5 pins. That's all Lee Jane Sin needs to advance. Take on the top seed. Rocío is waiting. Keep on the lane. Lee Jane's all good. Which she does, and she is. 10 down and a victory. Lee Jane Sin. All international final. She'll take on Rocío Restrepo from Colombia. A championship, prize money, and a trophy on the line. Lee Jane Sin, 225-194 winner over Stephanie Johnson from the Dallas Metroplex, and she advances on to take on Rocío Restrepo in the championship. Are you right-eyed or left-eyed? Understanding which of your eyes is dominant can improve your hand-eye coordination and possibly improve your game. In today's episode of USBC Bowling Academy, Rod Ross and Lou Marquez teach you how to understand the difference.
Now, there's several ways that you can find out their eye dominance, you know, right in the stance. And look and find out whether they're dominant eye. And I think a lot of players out there don't know whether they're right-eye or left-eye dominant.
And that's true, and we've seen from countless videos, you know, that a certain person is uniquely either more left eye dominant or right eye dominant. And when you ask them, you know, when they're looking at their target, what are you looking at? And obviously they may miss in or out depending on their eye dominance. We'll find that it can be a considerable number, any range from within one board to as much as 8.
So let's take a look at how we can measure to see what your eye dominance and how it affects your stance.
So we're now at our next player, Sasha, and we're going to look at eye dominance. And we're going to look specifically at her typical eye dominance and determine whether it's left eye dominant or right eye dominant. So Sasha, what I want you to do at this little test that we're going to perform on you is create a circle with your index finger and your thumb. Place it about a foot, foot and a half away from your face. And we want you to look at the number 1 on the masking unit. And with the number 1 enclosed in the center of the circle, what we want you to do is close your left eye and see if the number is actually staying in that center of that circle. Mm-hmm. And close your right eye, please. Does it still stay in the circle?
No.
No. Okay, so what we've determined was that we can actually see the dominance of the eye and keeping the focus internally into the circle, looking at the object in front of us. So we determined that Sasha is right eye dominant. And what we're going to now do is make sure that her setup is in alignment with her dominant eye. So what we'll do is check to see if her position in the beginning is adequate for her dominant eye. So right now she's actually more centered, so we're going to get her lined up. We're also going to make sure that her spinal tilt is in the right location, making sure that her dominant eye is over the ball. And that should be a good position for her to start with. With Sasha's alignment now set, what we're going to make sure is making sure that hand and eye coordination is set. So she'll actually swing the ball, keeping it underneath her dominant eye, and deliver it down the lane to her target.
USBC Bowling Academy provides hundreds of hours of high-quality instructional videos for bowlers of all skill levels. Learn from Team USA and USBC certified gold coaches, as well as other top pros and instructors. Visit usbcbowlingacademy.com today for more information. We are set for the finalists, Restrepo and Sin. Only one will be a champion of the PWBA Tour. We'll have the championship match for you coming up next on CBS Sports Network. Time. Only one can take home the championship. Lee Jane Sin will start us off. 225-194 win over Stephanie Johnson in the second match. Playing for all the marbles now. Light hit, missed the pocket. 245 up.
Yeah, slight swing and a miss on that one. Accelerate at the bottom of the swing. Ball never had a chance to read. 2-4-5 spare. She'll go to the plastic ball. Plastic ball is going to hit the 2-pin directly on and deflect into the 5-pin and to the 4-pin.
Which it does. Good analysis, Kelly. Perfect. Right on the money. And the mark for Lee Jane Sin to begin the match. Always interested as we see Rocio begin, the top seed. What the top seed does. I know you get some warm-up during the show. Louisville, Ohio, just outside Akron. How do you stay mentally sharp watching the others and waiting?
Well, the girls will get 8 shots, 4 on each lane. If they strategize, they're going to watch the matches previously before getting on the telecast, and then they use their ball reps to give them some information. But it all comes down to instincts. Reading the lane, let the ball be their guide, and playing their A game.
One of the world's best. Good start, Restrepo.
Rocio's game from Team Colombia. 4-step approach. Big first step. Gets the ball a little bit late in the swing. Long, long strides. Torso forward. And almost like a slingshot with that release. Rocio bowled for 24 games, averaged 228.
Impressive numbers.
Gotta push, do something.
Right on top seed. Comes in high, right through the nose, leaves the 6. Second time she's been the number 1 seed, also the Minnesota Open last year, but she lost that.
Yeah, left lane's hooking a little bit more. I think she wanted to play deeper inside, but with that recoil, that slingshot follow-through I just mentioned, she over-rotates with the shoulders. Ball does not have a chance to get right at the head pin. That was definitely a physical execution gone poorly.
Also the 4 seed for the Las Vegas Open this season, lost to Liz Johnson. Opening match of the step ladder, 237-204. But in talking to her pre-match, she has got the ultimate confidence.
Yeah, she just missed the roll-off in Wichita as well. She's got this inner demon she's been channeling and defeating. And she's built her confidence over and over again. She's really making a great stride and a great run this year out on the ladies' tour.
Restrepo
Jameson gets some help on the 10. It goes down late for a first strike of the championship match.
Late fall on the 10 pin. See where she's sliding. 21-22, 15 at the arrow. She's moved deeper, or excuse me, she's moved further right on the lane on this right side because there's a hang spot down there. 44 feet. Ooh, she likes that one.
Breakdown, left lane, right lane strikes. It's high, four pin.
So we've had two matches bowled on this pair so far. A lot of aggressive ball surface on the balls themselves. Fronts are starting to go away a little bit, might make the lane a little bit tighter down the back portion of the lane. So they're going to have to move parallel inside, two and two, three and two. What I mean by that is two or three with your feet and one or two with your target at the arrow zone.
Has the mark. Well, Sia talked to us yesterday, Kelly, about not being afraid to play any part of the lane. Has her versatility improved in her game?
Absolutely. I mean, just by the amount of shows she made, she hasn't been dominant on short, medium, or long. She's been a contender each time on each pattern. So she's worked with Del Ballard in the past, worked on her ball roll, and now she's always going to be a competitor each week.
Crunching into that 1-3 pocket. Best shot either bowler so far in the championship match. That was blitz right through all 10 back of the pit.
Look at her physical game from behind. First step is large. Drops the ball in the slot underneath her shoulder. Heel toe, left arm, her hand is directly upside down, but her left arm comes directly behind her back. A lot of rotation in that torso and in the shoulders. She's in great physical shape, trying to channel that core to give her some push as well.
Back-to-back strikes. Down goes the 10 late.
Watch the ball motion through the pins. Six pin lays in front in the gutter. Just tickles a 10 pin. Ooh, she's a lion. She's so scary right now. She's got a lot of confidence.
Five-time Colombian national champion. And a great bowler at Wichita State. Two-time team champ there. Lee Jane Sin comes in high and pays the price.
Trouble for Jane.
4-6-7.
Yeah, okay, so Jane has definitely moved right. 22-15 at the arrows where the other girls are starting to move deeper. She picked up that friction spot early on the lane. Hits the head pin directly on the nose for that 4-6-7.
Trying to convert. And leaves the six pin open frame. She didn't face a 7-10 there, but any player who converts a 7-10 split on our CBS Sports Network finals will receive a $100,000 bonus courtesy of Ultimate Bowling Products.
Fourth frame, she's already down by 24 pins. Now long patterns, you always want to migrate left. Even on the light hits, it's just kind of keep the head pin, three pin in play, and continue to move deeper inside or continue to move left. Kind of like a fade or fallback shot.
It's a high shot again, though. 3-6 up, trying to find that 1-3 pocket. Misfires.
Yep, rule of thumb. Ball hooks, keep chasing it left. She's much deeper here on the left lane, 17-18 at the arrows. 12-13, 44 feet. But the ball is too aggressive, comes up high. She's going to continue to have to move deeper inside the lane in order to get more left to right. Looks like Rocio's talking to herself a little bit. That third person.
Continuing the confidence. strikes in three of the first four frames. Told you about our TV show in Vegas. One by Liz Johnson. Trying to stay hot. That comes in high, though, and leaves the three. Could have been worse.
She's much deeper on the left lane than she is the right. But with that recoiling in her shoulders that we said, has a tendency sometimes to push and miss inside of our target. With the longer oil, the ball pushes down the lane, but that is a very lucky break for Rocio right now. Makes fair. She's got a strong lead going in the sixth frame. 23 pins ahead.
Told us yesterday she feels as good about her game as she ever has. Her confidence is sky high, and that's what you want heading to TV.
Yeah, she competed full-time last year with the opening tour coming back in the 15th season. And you'll see a lot of repeat customers, a lot of repeat players making their way to the finals.
Ball 10 down. And a great lead for Rocio Restrepo, trying for her first career tour title. The number one seed is in great shape. You will see Lee Jane Sin can rally in the second half of the match. Restrepo looks good for now. U.S. Open Bowling Tournament will take place at the South Point Bowling Plaza in Las Vegas, November 3rd through the 9th. For more information on how to take part in one of bowling's most prestigious events, visit bowl.com/U.S. Open. International champ so far this year. We'll have one in this event. Pretty slim with the Rubik's Cube. So impressive with the Queens in Vegas from Singapore. Her Singapore teammate Sherry Tan won as well. And Clara Guerrero, a major championship for her first career title. Great bowlers from overseas, no question about it, Kelly. Gotta be tough for you and fellow bowlers to compete against.
We do, we need the members, we need the participation. We've bowled their events, they're just coming over and sharing the love and bowling ours.
High shot. Unable to find that 1-3 pocket. Lee Jane Sin in serious trouble. The way Rocio's bowling, it's a 25-pin match, but Restrepo looks locked in. And you said it earlier, just the confidence through the roof.
Absolutely, Dave. She's keeping the ball in play. Basically just hitting that 1-3. You know, a 9 count is good on this pattern. You don't have to average 250. You don't have to shoot 270 to win. Keep the ball in play. Leave makeable spares. And that's exactly what she's doing. Jay now on this left lane. She's got to make a big step left. That's what it comes down to. She's been high, high, high every single time. Using the same ball, not going to change bowling balls, but she's got to take that jump left about 4 or 5 boards, move her target 2 or 3 with her, parallel a little bit more. See if she can get the ball to push through the front portion of the lane and hit that 1-3. Two, four, five, eight. She made the move. She made the move, Dave, but looks like she accelerated a little bit at the bottom of the swing. Ball doesn't tip up enough. Hits a 3-pin face on. 2-4-5 bucket spare conversion again.
A familiar sight, the bucket, unfortunately. Throughout our broadcast, third time we've seen it. Twice for Lee Jane Sin.
Help out.
That looked off right from the release, and she is now in a massive hole. 41 pin deficit with the open frame this late. The way Rocio is bowling, that could spell curtains for Lee Jane Sin. We'll find out. Rocio now can take advantage. Got a chance to go up by 51 with a strike here. focused in the zone. Four gets a nudge, but stands, but still the nine pin count. As Kelly talked about on this oil pattern, that's probably enough.
Yeah, fantastic delivery there. Again, the players, again, they're not going to average 250. You're not going to see some of the big scores sometimes. Getting out of the gate on the first condition, you just have to keep the ball in play. Nine spare is good. And Rocio, with her 14 years experience on Team Colombia, she's in commanding lead and commanding control of the match right now.
No problem. Single pin spare conversion. Maintains the big edge heading into the eighth frame.
Sometimes you want something so bad you can taste it. And occasionally it backfires on you because you're trying too hard. But with Rocio's confidence right now, she's like willing it to happen. She knows she has the control within her hand and in her delivery.
Late hit on number seven. And she's pumped up. The most emotion we've seen from Rocio in this championship match, and the one seed is inching closer to a title.
Yeah, don't let her petite frame fool you, folks. I wouldn't want to go near her right now. Look at this reaction, though. Scary. Forty-one pins down for Jane. Eighth frame. Match isn't over. Still have a few frames left, but the stat pack shows 2-for-8 for strikes for only Jane, 5-for-8 for Rocio. Spare conversions, Rocio is clean through the match. And 2 opens for Jane. Hence the 41 pin deficit.
Rocio strikes 3 of the first 4 frames and really established herself from the beginning of this match as being in command. Nice finish. Stretch run here for Lee Jane Sin. The double, 8th and 9th. But still, she's down by 31 pins. Strepo works on a strike. Foundation frame, and she is getting closer to a title.
Yeah, with that strike by Jane, gives her a max score of 198. Rocio can strike out for 239. Look at her dig her fingers into the bowling ball. I love watching the athletes bowl.
Talking to herself, talking to the pins. Wants to see that.
Come on!
And she has another one. And the energy and the emotion all coming out for Rocio Restrepo here. She is getting close to a championship.
That was the clincher for Rocio right there. She just needs a good pin count.
Just needs 7 to shut out Lee Jane Sin on the bench and win her first title.
Seven pins, folks.
She'll take 9. She'll take home the championship. Rocio Restrepo, for the first time in her career, is a winner on the PWBA Tour. Tiger early in the match, and now the emotions are coming up for Rocio Restrepo. And she's got a standing ovation because she's won on the PWBA Tour for the first time. What a feeling. The glasses are off, the match is in hand, and she's done it.
Great job.
Classic line from ball rep and Hall of Famer Del Ballard Jr. There's no crying and mowing. Sure there is, Kelly. You've got to cry a little bit, show that emotion. All the hard work. We heard her say it, and she's delivered.
Yes, she has. Indeed, she has. You know, Rocio is one of the girls. She does wear her emotions on her sleeve. She's got the saying on her neck collar, Isaiah. She's a firm believer in her faith. She's a hard worker on the lane, so she's put in the time. And she's earned this title today.
What did it feel like for you, your first title?
I cried too. 2003, the US Open. 3 years on tour, it took me to win my first title. And I beat Carolyn Doran Ballard for the title.
Is that right?
Yep.
And her husband Dale is helping out Rocio here as a ball rep. 217-185, the final. And history for Rocio Restrepo, her first ever championship. Time to get that trophy.
We have two Singapore winners this year, two Colombian winners this year. And you're looking at your 2016 PWBA Greater Detroit Open Champion.
PWBA Greater Detroit Open on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Smithfield. Flavor hails from Smithfield. Get inspired at smithfield.com today. By Nationwide. Nationwide is on your side. And by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the PWBA Tour.
Rocio Restrepo wins her first career title, 217-185, in the championship match over Lee Jane Sin of Malaysia. Time for the Smithfield moment of the match. Eighth frame. Look at the emotion from Rocio. Pretty excited. She's got a championship. Diane and Mark Boyd, proprietor of Super Bowl Canton, Michigan. Trophy presentation now with Rocio.
Rocio, congratulations on your first ever Professional Women's Bowling Association title. You have won numerous medals for Team Columbia, but this being your first professional title, please tell the fans at home how it feels.
Oh my God, I don't even have words right now. I'm so excited, so happy. It finally happened, and I'm just very thankful for the proprietors at the Canton, Michigan. You know, I'm out of words. It's been a really hard road, and it finally happened. So excited.
Good for you. Congratulations. Please tell us, you have Isaiah on your collar. What does that mean? Please describe to everybody.
It basically says that God is with me all the time, and he's my strength. And that's all I did this whole week. Just kept reminding me that I have him. I'm nothing without him and everything with him. So I'm just excited that I'm able to display what I believe and what I am, and thanks to him.
Rocio, you are a true champion. Congratulations on your victory, your first professional title. Well done, the Greater Detroit Open champion.
Thank you.
Dave, back to you.
Kelly, thanks. Such an emotional moment for Rocio Restrepo from Colombia. Grabs that championship trophy. First time, she hopes, of what will be many more opportunities to win a title on the PWBA Tour. Congratulations to Rocio Restrepo, winner of the PWBA Greater Detroit Open. Be sure to join us next Tuesday, July 26, 7:30 Eastern Time for the Under 12 Junior Gold Championships. Then August 7th for the U.S. Women's Open at 12 Eastern from Addison, Illinois, outside Chicago. For Kelly Kulik and the entire CBS Sports Network crew,